A former UH quarterback is coming home.
The night before UH's final football game of the season, a new head coach is named.
This is the KHON2 News at 6 with Joe Moore.
Good evening, everybody, and thank you for joining us on this Aloha Friday.
Joe has the night off. The University of Hawaii has a new head football coach, the announcement made just about an hour ago.
Sam Spangler joins us with all the late-breaking details. Sam?
That's right, Des. The University of Hawaii is rolling out the red carpet for one of their own. UH announced today Nick Rolovich is the 23rd head coach of the Rainbow Warriors, replacing Norm Chow. Former star quarterback for Hawaii from 2000 to 2001, Rolo was also an offensive assistant and offensive coordinator from 2008 to 2011 in Manoa. Now, since not being retained when Norm Chow took over, Rolovich became offensive coordinator at Nevada in 2012 when he led the Wolfpack to two bowl games and an offense that averaged ranking fifth in the Mountain West during his tenure. He had a high of second in the league during his inaugural season back in 2012. Now, during his time as offensive coordinator back at UH in 2010, White led the nation in passing and finished sixth in total offense, a year in which the Warriors had a share of the WAC title. The 36-year-old becomes the fifth youngest coach in FBS subdivision, beating out fellow finalists June Jones, Rich Miano, Brian Norwood, and Rich Ellerson. Rolovich and Nevada play at San Diego State tomorrow. He'll call plays in that one. He'll fly in and be introduced at a press conference on Monday. Dash Marissa, will send it back to you.
Alrighty, Sam, so a lot of questions that everybody has. Rich Miano, known as a great recruiter. Okay, if he's not the head coach, what is the likelihood that he, Chris Nioli, some of the other former Rainbows, are going to be part of Rolo's staff?
Now, I know a lot of those guys want to stay, and I've talked to Rich before, and he wants to stay at the University of Hawaii. He wants to stay in Hawaii and coach here. Obviously, he's had a lot of success in high school, a lot of success when he was recruiting at the University of Hawaii. And we talked to a lot of high school kids who love Rich Miano, so that'd be a good recruiting asset to Nick Rolovich's staff.
And Sam, do you think that Rolovich has what it takes to give the program what it needs? Immediate ticket sales, sponsorships as well?
Yeah, immediate ticket sales is one thing, but I think long-term success is what David Matlin's looking towards, and that's wins. You know, at the end of the day, you can talk about finding a big name. You know, June Jones might have been the big name that brings in a bunch of sponsors right off the bat, but you have to look at the long-term success of this program, and I think that David Matlin looked towards that. And if you look at what he did with Ron Gannat, the head basketball coach, very similar hire, a young, energetic guy who wants to stay at the University of Hawaii and help this place prosper. And I think Nick Rolovich is that guy for him. And moving forward, I think when you talk about wins, I think he's the guy who can bring him in.
All right. Good stuff. Thanks so much, Sam.
Sam, thank you, buddy.
Big news. Now, the news does come as a pleasant surprise for many we spoke with tonight. Alexander Zanes continues our coverage live from Manoa. Alexander.
Thanks, guys. I'm here at UH. The UH football team just getting off of the field. Their senior night practice ahead of their senior night game with University of Louisiana Monroe. Now, the players and coaches have already been notified. They were notified just before the release went out. And, of course, the Rainbow Warriors' next head coach, Nick Rolovich, like Sam was saying, the football team held a closed practice today, but we caught up with some fans of the program, including a current player's family, to get reaction to this selection.
I coached here before, and that's all I know about him. I spent a little bit of time with him during the recruiting when Ben was being recruited and stuff, and he sounds like he has a good relationship in the NFL and with the college, NCAA college circuit, so that's great for us.
I know the name, and I've seen what he's done before. Although he hasn't been, you know, the head coach before, I think he'll do a great job, and yeah. I think Hawaii's going to be behind him.
So far, everyone we've talked to, the reaction overwhelmingly positive. We're on now tonight for 9 and 10 o'clock. We're going to try to get you some reaction with UH students. Alexander Zanes, reporting live, KHON 2 News.
Alexander, thank you. The UH football head coach is one of the highest paid state employees. Norm Chow was paid $550,000 a year before he was fired earlier this month. Chow was the head coach for nearly four seasons, but lost 36 of the 46 games he coached. Before Chow was coach Greg McMackin. He was paid $1.1 million a year. The new coach stands to get paid less. UH officials had previously told lawmakers they're making changes to negotiating head coach contracts.